Hey, just down below the video, if you click like, that'll make sure that YouTube shows this video to more people.
They say, if you do something you love, you never have to work a day in your life. That's certainly the case here. It's been 25 years today that I've been sharing my Excel tips and videos and seminars with you. I appreciate you being there. I'm always excited when I have something new to show, and today I think I have something amazing. Let's take a look.
Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2635. Publish any Excel logic to a web app using Sheetcast, protecting your intellectual property. Or search 25 years of Mr. Excel content using 18 Excel functions. Okay, what's the Excel shortcut for today's date? It's Ctrl semicolon. And if I want to calculate the number of years between two dates, the YEARFRAC from the earlier date to the later date, today, I can't believe this, it's been 25 years since I published my very first article at Mr. Excel. With a column of data with daily dates, use the day function to insert a new column of monthly dates in order to further analyze the data by month in a pivot table or subtotals. Look at that, I didn't even have the EO month function back then because it was still part of the analysis tool pack, which most people weren't allowed to install. I went back to the Wayback Machine and that first run there, this is the first snapshot of the Wayback Machine. It looks like almost weekly Excel articles being published. Now the hassle with 25 years of content means that I'm 25 years older than when I started, which means that I might remember that I'd done something, but where did I do it? But what I'm really excited about today, just under a week ago, I met with the guys at Sheetcast. They said they had a way to create a web app in minutes using any Excel workbook. So you know how to build logic in Excel, you upload it to Sheetcast, and all of a sudden you have a web app. It's a common question. You don't want to give your Excel file to someone. There's a lot of intellectual property in there, but you want the calculations in Excel to work. So as I was talking to the Sheetcast folks, I said, well, geez, what would be a cool way that I could build a web app that might be useful, that might be a stretch for the Sheetcast app? You know, I said to them, do you support all the functions? They said, almost all the functions. Oh, well, that's like a challenge. Let's see if we can break it. I mean, let's face it. If you're going to put a product to the test, some good functions to throw at it would be the image function, HSTACK, filter. So just this past Friday, I built this little workbook with three Excel sheets and not many Excel formulas. This is a great way for me or anyone to go look for the YouTube videos that I've created. For example, if I search for the phrase publish web, I see this episode 1432 from September 2011, another episode from 2016. It's a great way to find things. Here, let's try another one. Let's do pivot table calculated field, and it comes back with several different videos about calculated fields. Or if I would search for subtotals horizontal or replicate pivot table or Python. All right, so let's take a look at the logic behind this. We'll go with pivot table calculated field and by not the. All right, as people type in a search phrase, the first thing you have to do is think about the tiny words that you don't want to search for because they're going to be in every single video, like the and. Those are called stop words. There's a great database out on the web. I pulled that into here and named the range as stop words. That was step number one. So our first question, for each of these 2400 videos, how close of a match is it to the phrase pivot table calculated field? Up in this formula here, I create a match score, and the basics of this is to take the length of the original text minus the length of that original text once I remove the word pivot. So the substitute in the original text, remove pivot, and replace it with quote, quote, and then divide that by the length of the word pivot. That'll give me the number of times that it appeared. I don't want to do that for just the one word. I want to do it for all the words. So this little hash here, B1 hash, is the array operator. Let's just take a look at this result. So pivot occurs 185 times in this video, 95 times for table, 0 times for calculated, and 50 times for field. It was good that this one was at the top because I started to think about that. There's a lot of videos that mention a pivot table field, but I definitely need the word calculated there. So over here, I did a little test to look for the smallest number in those four numbers. In that case, in B, we would have a 0. And then said, if there's one word here that had 0 matches, then put a 0 for the match score. Otherwise, sum up the values. That's a pretty intense formula, given that the text in column H is often more than 5,000 characters. Double click to copy that down. Count how many are greater than 0. And then find the fifth largest one. Unless there's not 5 that match, then use the smaller number. So right there, that cell B3 tells me what match score and above I'm looking for. So let's come back to the presentation layer here, where I filter my database for everything where the score in column I is larger than the fifth largest score. That should get me 5 results. Sometimes there'll be a tie and I'll get 5, 6, 7. So in the first two columns, I'm getting the title and the date that it was published, and then the image function, same filter here to get the images, and then finally the watch link. I'd really hope that I could make these into hyperlinks, but unfortunately it's not working. Take those three arrays and horizontally stack them into a single result. Now, hey, look, I thought that was a pretty cool little web app. It's actually useful for me because I can go back and find videos that I know that I've created in the past. It potentially might be interesting to you in case you were ever searching for a particular video that you remember from the past. Yes, YouTube has a search, but they're not searching the transcript. And for the longest time, when I started the YouTube channel, I really thought the video was the important thing. I would create a great video, upload it, and then just put a 2-sentence description, figuring if you wanted to know what it was about, you could watch the video. Ah, that's horrible for SEO. And over the past few months, we've spent a lot of time here to put out full descriptions for all 2,400 videos. But it's the subtitle file that really tells you everything that's mentioned in the video. So this is Tuesday morning. It was just a few days ago on Friday morning when I sent that Excel workbook over to Sheetcast and said, hey, could we do a demo where you show me how Sheetcast could put this workbook on the web? I honestly figured I had used some functions that probably were going to throw them for a loop. But here we are. It's Tuesday morning. And yesterday, end of day on Monday, they said, yeah, here's a great explanation. Now, they offered to come in here and teach me how to build this myself. I said, hey, it's pretty late. Tomorrow's the 25th anniversary. Let's publish something right now, and then we can talk about building later. They promised me that it would take 5 or 10 minutes to take my Excel workbook and convert it to this amazing web app. And I've asked them to create a URL where you can go try it as well. I'll put that URL down in the YouTube description right at the top. All right, so this is pretty amazing. This is their result. They apologized that it didn't look better. They said they tried to use some of the same colors that I used, and they could teach me how to customize this more. But the real question is, can we search and get the results? Let's search for stock quotes. There we are, the stock history, introducing free stock quotes in Excel, stock data types, and how to use the new geography data types, which must have mentioned stock quotes as well. This is really pretty mind-blowing. First, that I gave them a fairly complicated worksheet with 18 different functions on Friday, and on Monday, I now have a web app that's actually working that replicates all of the logic that I knew how to build in Excel. The next time that you have some amazing Excel workbook that you want to share, but you don't want your lookup tables and other intellectual property to get out there, check out this amazing new tool at Sheetcast.com. A quarter of a century, it's sort of amazing. Seems like a long time. Thanks to everyone at MrExcel. Thanks to everyone who's left a comment on the video, watched the video, participated in the MrExcel message board. The MrExcel store this week for Thanksgiving through Cyber Monday, 25% off all Excel ebooks using the coupon 25 years. I'll put that link down in the YouTube description. You know, and a shout out to everyone at the Mr. Excel board. What an amazing community of really smart people about Excel with 5.7 million messages and over a million threads. That first 6 months, it was me writing an Excel article every week. When I launched the Mr. Excel message board, it opened the Mr. Excel community up to an amazing community of people who can solve Excel problems anytime that I can't figure anything out. This is my first place to come. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Okay, I'm going to teach you how to search in reverse. Repeat after me. It's easy with five little words. Concat, left, right, sequence, lend. Your turn. Concat, left, right, sequence, lend. That's how you search in reverse. That's how you turn it around. It's just five little words. Concat, left, right, sequence, lend. Gap, left, right, sequence, lend. Concat, left, right, sequence, lend. Concat, left, right, sequence, lend. I think you got it.